Hello and good day. I am Dr. Vivek Babu Bojawar, Senior and Lead Consultant CT Surgeon at SLG Hospitals, Hyderabad. I have got more than 15 years of experience in cardiac surgery, and we do all kinds of cardiac and thoracic procedures here at SLG Hospitals. Today I am going to talk about valvular surgery, valvular heart disease surgery. When you look at the heart has got four chambers. We call it the divided into right side and the left side. You have a right atrium and right ventricle. You have left atrium and left ventricle. These chambers are surrounded by, are guarded by structures called valves. These valves have to open and open during every heartbeat so that the blood can flow in one direction to the rest of the organs. And then they have to close when the heart is relaxing. So each beat, these valves open and then close off. So if you take, for example, in a year, nearly if you take a heart rate of 80 times, so nearly 1 crore times these valves have to open and close in a year. So because these valves are so vital to the function of the heart, there are various diseases which can afflict these heart valves. So there are four heart valves which are of importance to us in cardiac surgery. There is a valve on the right side. There are two valves called the tricuspid valve and the pulmonary valve, and the left side there are two valves called the mitral valve and the aortic valve. It is the mitral valve and the aortic valve which are very important and which are actually mostly diseased in adult patients, whereas pulmonary valve and tricuspid valve diseases are more common in children. So one of the ways the heart valves can be damaged can either be by either they have a block, that means they cannot open properly. So what we call stenosis. So we have two types of stenosis, a mitral stenosis or an aortic stenosis. Or sometimes what happens, the valves don't close properly, in which case there is a leak called regurgitations. So when it leaks, instead of pushing the blood in one direction to the body, when there is a leak, the blood returns back to the heart. So it is a wasted pumping action of the heart. So this results in increased workload for the heart. So these diseases affecting the mitral and tricuspid aortic valves are different. Whereas aortic valves diseases are mostly because of old age. So because, as I told earlier, when the heart has to open, when the valves have to open nearly 1 crore times every year, once you reach a certain age, say 65 to 70 years of age, the valves slowly start degenerating, slowly becoming old and become rusted, or calcium gets deposited in the valves. So this results in something called aortic stenosis, which is a common problem. In India, now that we have a lifespan of 75 to 80 years, we are seeing a lot of people, elderly people above 60, 65 coming with aortic stenosis. So these patients who have aortic stenosis usually may often be asymptomatic. We may have a normal lifespan, normal activities and all. But in later stages, usually they get serious symptoms. They can get breathlessness. They cannot even walk 1 kilometer. They will become very breathless. Sometimes they get chest pain. Chest pain is not only due to heart attack. Chest pain can also be because of aortic valve. Sometimes if the valve obstruction is very tight, blood flow to the brain may be hindered, and then they can become dizzy and fall off. They can get syncopal attacks. Apart from aortic valve, the other valve which is of significance is the mitral valve. Mitral valve is usually affected in slightly younger people, in 30s and 40s. And there is a disease called rheumatic heart disease which tends to affect this mitral valve. Rheumatic heart disease, usually we get it in childhood, at the age of 10 to 15 years of age. And then it takes around 10-15 years of age for the disease to manifest itself. So usually patients coming with mitral valve disease usually come in around 35 to 40 years. Sometimes they can even present at 50-55 years of age. So both these types of valve diseases are very common because they are not compatible with long life. So what happens is, when there is a valve disease, because the blood is not flowing properly, you have breathing difficulty, you cannot even lie down properly, you'll be breathless, then you'll get swelling of the legs, you can get fluid in the lungs, you can have tiredness, increasing tiredness, you won't be able to eat anything because the heart is not functioning properly. So all these problems, what we call heart failure. So they can go into heart failure if these valves are not working properly. So how do we treat this patients? I've just got a picture here to show you the different types of valves which are affected. This is the mitral valve, which is on the left side, and there is an aortic valve. So either this mitral valve or this aortic valve can be diseased in a patient. Sometimes both the valves can also be diseased in the same patient. So how do we treat these cases? In early stages, in a stenosis where there is an obstruction, what you call stenosis, usually there is no treatment. The treatment is usually to replace the valve, to take care of the stenosis, to relieve the stenosis. Whereas when there is a leak, usually you can give some medicines to control the leak. So what we call, you tend to reduce the regurgitation by giving medicines. The ultimate treatment for both the types of valve problems, either stenosis and obstruction, is a valve repair or is a surgery, either with a valve repair or valve replacement. And mitral valve is very amenable for repairing. So when there is a leak, when there is a mitral valve leak or aortic valve leak, because the valves are often quite pliable, they are quite mobile and not very diseased, you can do repair for these valves. So mitral valve is mitral regurgitation. You can do a surgical repair rather than doing a replacement. Whereas in patients who have stenosis, like aortic stenosis or mitral stenosis, often we have to do replacement. So both these type of surgeries are open heart surgeries, where we have to stop the heart, put the heart on heart-lung machine, and then replace the valves. So there are various types of valves which are commercially available. Depending on the age of the patient and the activity level of the patients, we choose the valves. So the valves can either be mechanical valve or metallic valves. These metallic valves are long lasting. They can last for 30 years, 40 years, 50 years, like our own heart valves. Or they can be tissue valves. These tissue valves are usually prepared from cow valves or even pig valves. So these valves, because they're prepared from some other animal tissue, usually don't last for long. So the tissue valves are usually used in elderly people who have a slightly shorter lifespan. Whereas mechanical valves are used in younger people who are in 30, 40. So anyone above 60, 65, we tend to put a tissue valve. Anyone below 60, 65, we tend to put a metallic valve. And this surgery, with open heart surgery, nowadays we have... There are various other advances in surgery which can make this whole process very easy. So instead of doing a full open surgery, we can do a minimal invasive surgery. So in minimal invasive surgery, usually we approach the heart through the right-sided incision, and then we do a small incision or a 5 cm incision and do the surgery. You need specialized equipment. You need to be properly trained for these things. I've had the training for mitral valve surgeries and minimal invasive surgery in Australia. So I am capable of doing this minimal invasive surgeries. So we can do these surgeries even at SLG hospitals, where we do the surgery through a small incision. So the advantages are patients can go back to their routine activity much faster than when we do an open surgery. Now there is another advancement in valve replacement called TAVR. TAVR or TAVI. It's a procedure where it is not even, we don't need to even cut. We just need to replace the valve through your groin, through the leg region. We can just replace through the artery itself. But that's a very expensive surgery generally. So it is not affordable to a lot of patients. But the regular valve surgery can be done minimally invasive, and it is as good as an open heart surgery. So once you have valve surgery, depending on what type of valves you get, you have to be on treatment. Usually once you have a valve surgery or open heart surgery, you are a heart patient, like diabetes or hypertension, you need to take medicines for lifelong. You need to take some blood thinning tablets called acetrom, which generally keeps the valve smooth and helps preventing any blood clot formation on the valves. The recovery again is similar to any other open heart surgery, usually takes around 2 to 3 weeks. In minimal invasive surgery, it's slightly faster recovery. In open surgery, it takes some time. But usually, by 1 month, you can get back to your work. You can do your complete. You can do your regular activities. You can even go cycling and go for jogging, cycling, and all the other regular activities. Thank you.